100 to begin the campaign. Swing and a liner, but foul.
It's not good.
Runners on the move for second. A pitch out. The throw. On a great time to pitch out as he'll be thrown out easily at second.
If you're not an absolute speed merchant on the bases, if the pitcher slide steps, he's got a much better chance of throwing you out. The defense sniffed it out right there. The slide step worked. Great throw to second base, and he's gone.
And he'll fall behind now to 1-2. 1-2, here it comes. Swing, line, drive. That's going to be trouble.
Excellent.
He's around first on his way to second now. And he's in there safely. He's got a double.
All right, everybody. I'm Lonnie from thelonnie.com.
He's going to get his hit streak to six games
doing
now.
Doing
so
some MLB The Show.
Second baseman.
John Avery will stand in.
Had a little bit of profanity on my first video this morning. Somebody decided to comment.
Well,
so, I disabled comments.
And he takes ball four. So now at least they're set up for the force at any base here with two away.
Man, a little surprising they didn't challenge him there. You know, there are certain guys you just have to make earn their way aboard. This isn't exactly the most dangerous guy in the lineup.
Keo Saar gets a shot now with deuces all around. Two on, two out here in inning number two. Has to be thinking strikeout here. Popped up. Roberts is there for it. Makes the catch, and that'll retire the side. A couple of walks, but no damage. Through an inning and a half, no score on the show.
I got on base. Made it all the way to second. That's about all I can do at this point.
Here, looking to make something happen with two gone in the bottom of the second.
Hoping to get enough points where I can maybe
Pitch swung on and hit in the air. Right fielder has a beat on it.
Maybe I can make some more get a few more attribute points. Make a player a little better today.
Jack Martinez will stand in here. He was set down on strikes to start the home first.
Full of energy this morning. Don't know when in the world I'm going to go to sleep. But
hit the other way out toward right field. Right fielder is on the run. He gets there, but missed it.
Come on.
Around second. He'll try for third. And he's going for it all. Headed for the plate. And he is in there.
Wow. An error. I don't even know.
Yeah, you know.
I was under the ball waiting for it. He just didn't catch it.
Number 83.
I know that looks great on the scouting report.
Into the windup and the pitch. Lifted in the air out to right. Miltiades on the move.
Oh, come on.
Lays out and he's got it. A great play for out number two.
Just an outstanding play out there by the outfielder, and the guy who appreciates it more than
the guy basically had to make a highlight reel play to catch that.
Oliver Nunez.
I'll just take it where I can get it. Whatever.
As we get started here in the bottom of the fifth.
See if I can actually catch this one.
Skied into
straightaway right.
It's
basically the same
thing. Long run for the right fielder, but he won't get to it.
And no.
Put him in scoring position to start the inning. And he'll round it and try
for third. Let's go ahead and get another in-the-park home run.
And he will make it all the way to third now as that mistake proves a
costly one indeed. Making errors left and right. I don't know what's up. I need more speed, maybe some more throwing power.
Number 83.
Something,
we'll
I don't know.
One for two with a double in this one.
But my player's not looking good at all.
Sends that one out of play for strike one.
He's a pretty decent batter, and that's about all he's got going for him. So.
Another one fouled off, and he's quickly
and behind 0-2. Nice.
Hits are now even at four apiece. Did a good job to shorten up and protect the plate, and he'll have another shot at it here.
Oh.
Set to deliver on nothing and two. Here it comes. Hit sharply toward the right side.
Nice.
And that finds some outfield grass. It's a base hit.
You know, I'll take that after the night I've had so far.
And at this point, I don't think you could expect anything less than a two-hit ball game from this guy. I mean, he's been as hot as anybody lately, and he comes through again here.
At the plate, John Avery, as the switch hitter will take his cuts left-handed here. Now that's popped up, calling for it, Campos. And the inning is over. So they pick up a run on two hits, no errors, and a man left. Julian Vasquez stands into the box. He could really use a knock here. 0 for 3 in the game so far. Fly ball out to right field. Right fielder giving chase.
Yeah.
He doesn't have a chance. It's over his head. Digging hard, he's headed for third. And he will make it into third with a one-out triple. Number 83.
That's like a guaranteed triple every time they hit it towards me.
To really get something
guaranteed.
And their chances of getting back into this ball game are growing dimmer by the batter.
First pitch of the AB is swung on and lifted in the air to straightaway.
I wish I could catch like that.
Under it, and he makes the catch for out number three. Pretty painless half of the inning, all told. Steve Golden steps in and perhaps looking to drive another one out of the park, just like he did in the second. Hit in the air to right field. And this is taken in just shy of the warning track for out number one. Jason Blue.
Really, we're gonna have somebody else hit it out here.
Third strike his last time.
Well, you know, it never feels good to go down on strikes, especially looking. It wouldn't be surprised to see him be a little more aggressive in this at bat.
And eight innings have come and gone now as the inning is over. Nothing doing here this half. We've played eight.
All right, two hits with a double.
Pretty good offensive show of force in this one. Probably at least a couple of players deserving. But, gentlemen, let's go ahead and give this man the nod as our top player of the game.
Yeah, and I think we probably could have given this award to three or four different people. But you definitely can't overlook his contribution. He really played a great ball game.
So that's a wrap here tonight. For my partners in the booth, Eric Karros and Steve Lyons, and our entire crew, I'm Matt Vaskirjan. You've been watching MLB The Show. And for more, click on over to theshownation.com. The drillers strike oil here. They win it 7-6. Good night, everybody.
Six runs on 12 hits. Two errors.
Oh, nice. Here we go.
Time of the ball game, 3 hours and 37 minutes. Thank you for joining us here tonight. And we remind you to please drive home safely.
All right, next game, we'll see if we can advance a little bit.
Minor League Baseball, MLB The Show is on the air. Tonight, game
two
of this three-game series between the Corpus Christi Hooks and the Tulsa Drillers. And now we'll look at the starting lineup for the visitors.
Still batting 500.
Number 83 will get his first shot here. Couple of hits in four trips last night.
Well, you look at the average on the season, guys, and he's not sneaking up on anybody. Pretty amazing numbers for him right there. So yesterday's performance, obviously no fluke.
Swing and a liner. Foul. A runner on first with two away. Hit hard towards center. And that'll get down for a base hit.
Respectable.
Seven straight games with a base hit now, and that's a solid week or so of swinging the bat with some authority.
Rod Caudle.
Oh, yeah. .095
he's
average.
He's got to be wondering when his bat's going to make the trip north from spring training, as he has really struggled in the early going. That misses 1-2.
Well, this is the kind of situation where they came up short last night. They had opportunities, but they could never really cash them in. So you can bet they'd love to get something going on the board early here.
A little tapper. And the two-out threat will not come.
Hey, you almost made it.
The inning is over. So they get to him for a couple of hits in the inning here, but they've got
none. Yeah, you just do what you can, I guess.
Number 83 stands
number
in.
Number 83.
Hit in the air to right field. Moving under it, Miltiades.
Oh, well.
No trouble with this one, and the inning is over.
That's
nothing
just
across
batting 500.
Here
this
half. We'll head now to the home.
Seems
half
like
that's
where I'm
going to
stay.
The Hooks lead it 1-0. Number 83 now will dig in. 1-for-2 thus far. Line to the right side. And that's
excellent.
In for his second hit of the afternoon.
So far, he's throwing a lot of fastballs here early in the count. And these guys have picked up on that.
Rod Caudle will step in now. He's bounced out and flown out in his first two plate appearances. And here's a ball hit in the air. In there, a base hit. And that runner will go no further than second, as there are two aboard now.
Now batting.
Looking good.
Steps in and perhaps looking to drive another one out of the park, just like he did in the second. Runners are at first.
If this guy could drive us to the.
Here's a looping fly ball out to right. Oh, and this deflects right off him. And they will hold that runner over at third as
nice.
They move up only 90 feet, but the
bases
are
loaded.
One away.
Boy, and that was some kind of effort out there. Here's a look at it. He's charging in hard.
Oh, man, he like, look, he hit him right in the face.
Right,
that's rough.
John
one
Avery
out, so I'm not just going to be running. We're going to have to.
Grounded out and struck out in two trips.
Yep, not showing too much so far, but he's got a chance to make something happen right here. See if he can put those other ABs behind him.
To short, hit hard. And that's through into left, a base hit. Tried to make it home when he shouldn't have, and now
Run.
They got him hung up. And they're able to get the force at home for a big out number two.
Golly. That
Jason
was all my fault.
Blue, ready to
like
take another shot.
The direction
went down
of the
on strikes
running chain.
Last time up. Nobody out, runner on first.
I can't believe that. I really can't.
Driven to right field and deep. Going back is the right fielder, but he can't get to this one. It's off the wall. Around third and being waved on home. And they'll get a little closer here as the run comes across to score from first. It's now a 4-1 game.
I got nothing.
So a pivotal moment here, and digging in now, Rico Noel. But a single here could reduce the deficit to only one.
You know, sometimes guys get caught up in thinking about being the big hero. The key here, though, is just keep it simple. See the ball, hit the ball. Usually the best results come with that mindset.
Number 83 is there, and he makes the catch for the out. Number 83 will bat now, 2-for-3 in the ballgame.
Yeah, he's been solid at the plate for his team. One of the better performers in their lineup.
This game could be a lot more opened up.
Lifted in the air out to right. Miltiades giving chase. He tracks it down and makes the play to record the save. Jim Tanaka digs in to lead off the bottom of the eighth inning.
Well, you know, he's been on base twice in this one already, so let's see if he can do it again.
Pops this one up just beyond the infield on the right side. Avery backs up a bit, and he takes charge for the first out. So a big moment here in standing in Victor Miltiades. And he does so representing the possible go-ahead run.
Yeah, but you got to make sure that he doesn't try to do too much here. Just keep that line moving. Do something productive and give the next guy a chance as well.
And that'll get down out there near the wall. And the run will score all the way from first. It's a 4-4 game. And he's in at third. Number 83 stands in now with one down and a runner at first. That would be the go-ahead run if they can find a way to get him all the way around. Double play is in order, however. And that's in there. Base hit. And they'll have runners at the corners following the one-out single.
I don't even get excited about it anymore. I need to master this running, though, to keep that complete screw-up from happening again.
Rod Caudill settles in to hit in a critical moment in this.
Especially with the game on the line in the ninth inning.
This is a situation where you can't chase the ball. Up in the zone and get the ball in the air.
And they got him.
Well, never mind.
This is all about quickness with the right-handed pitcher on the mound. But here, they catch him in between steps at time, and the result is an easy pickoff.
Controls. Base running pre-pitch. Okay, just basically hit left. That's all.
Striding into the box, Rico Noel. He singled his last time up. Even at two balls and two strikes, here's the pitch. Hit high in the air down the right field line. Number 83 is there, and he has it for the out.
Oh, thank you, God.
Right here, you've got the right fielder shading just a bit towards the alley. And I thought he'd have two.
Victor Miltiades brings his bat to the plate now to get the bottom of the 11th underway.
And he's already been on base three times in this ballgame, so let's see if he can do it one more time.
0-2 count, here's the pitch. Pulled toward right center field. Number 83 is there, and he'll bring this one in. Fernando Campos will stand in now, hitless to this point, but with a chance to be a hero here.
Well, he knows better than anybody in that lineup that one swing could make up for a whole game's worth of struggles.
This pitch is popped up. Avery on the move. And they've come back to win it here in 11 innings.
Oh, well, that didn't have anything to do with me.
Well, you had the sense early on that this one was destined to go down to the wire, and sure enough, these guys are going to pull this one out here in walk-off fashion.
And as we wrap things up here, what do you say we name this guy right here as the recipient of our Topps Player of the Game Award?
Yeah, you see a couple of hits for him in the ball game. This one was tight throughout, but in the end, he really helped lead his guys to this victory.
So that'll put a wrap on things here this evening. For my partners Eric Karros and Steve Lyons, I'm Matt Vaskirjan. This has been a presentation of MLB The Show. For more, follow us on Twitter, at MLB The Show. The Drillers strike oil here. They win it 6-4. Good night, everybody.
Thanks for joining us this evening. And please drive home safely.
Okay, slowly but surely figuring things out. Slowly. Emphasis on slowly.
MLB The Show's coverage of minor league baseball is on the air as we continue our tour around the minor league. Today, the opener of this three-game set between the Corpus Christi Hooks and the Springfield Cardinals. Major League Baseball on The Show starts now. Striding into the box, Kevin Calderon, as he'll get his first opportunity in this one. Here's a looping fly ball out to right. Center fielder coming on, and he makes the catch for the second out.
Batting third, center fielder.
Number
if I just get an error-free game, I'll be good.
Getting the start here despite being out of the lineup last night. Ready with the first pitch. Here it comes. Oh, that one got the pitcher.
Oh, look at
that.
And
no play as he reaches first base safely.
Oh, my goodness. This guy is really starting to heat up now. That's eight straight games with a base hit. He's been fun to watch.
Rod Caudill will stand in, back in the lineup after getting the night off yesterday. Full count, here it comes. And he will take ball four. First and second now with nobody out.
Yep, a single and then a walk to start the inning. This is exactly how big innings get started. So they're set up now to maybe put
okay, there's actually a realistic shot that I might make it home. No outs, and I'm on second with two on.
Sar will stand in, and that average has to be a source of pride for him early on. He's got it up over 350 to start the new season.
And you know what, guys? He's got the third best batting average on the club.
Fastball called, strike three, and there's the first out of the inning.
Well, this is due justice for the guy on the mound. He probably should have had the strikeout.
Kevin Flores will get his first shot here. Two hits in five trips a night ago. Strike three called, and now he's one out away from getting out of this.
All right, it's show track time. You're going to see him jump out ahead quickly here, 0-2. What a great place to live as a pitcher. But then on that third pitch, that was close.
Eldon Griffin gets a shot now with deuces all around. Two on, two out here in inning number two. Here he comes on a ball and two strikes. Got him looking, and that ends the inning.
Crap.
No runs.
Nobody else can hit worth a flip.
On now to the bottom
of the second.
That's a
really nice little fountain there.
Number 83 stands in with two on and two out here in the third.
And you know, some guys just get better with runners in scoring position and two outs. This is a big at-bat for him right here, even though it's still early.
Yes.
Line drive. That's going to be trouble. Around third and being waved on home. The runner from second crosses the plate, and he's safe. And the score is the runner from first. It's a 2-0 ball game.
Now that might have just gotten me player of the game if it keeps going like this.
He wasn't waiting around. Just sitting on this one, and he's going to drive in both runners with a two-run double.
Rod Caudill is into the box, reached base via the walk in his first appearance. And he takes ball four. So now at least they're set up for the force at any base here with two away.
Now there are two ways you can...
Keo Sar steps into the box and we'll see what he can do here. Two on, two away, two home in the inning so far.
Well, this could be a huge inning, or maybe the end of the inning. This is,
and we'll have to leave it there as this is strike three, and that will retire the side. So two runs on just one lone hit, one error in the inning, and a couple of men left. Vince Adorno will dig in now, and as you can see, he's well over 300 here to start this new campaign. Swing and a flare hit toward right. Right fielder coming on.
Dang it.
He's not going to get to it, so the leadoff guy's aboard with a base hit. And he has started the home third with the double. Number 83 will dig in here.
Okay, at least he didn't score on that.
Yeah, and I like the at-bats he's had.
Looking very confident and fluid at the plate, Matt.
Line drive to center
yes.
field. That gets down, and he's got himself a base hit.
And I'm just on top of it in this game.
Well,
I could even halfway make an excuse for that missed ball
so
earlier.
It was looking like he turned a corner and was on his way to a much-needed 1-2-3, but he's going to have to get in the stretch here after all.
Rod Caudill stands in, reached on a walk in his last trip. Line to the right side, and that finds some outfield grass. It's a base hit, and that runner will go no further than second as there are two aboard now.
Yeah, he's a pitch away from heading back to the dugout.
Tio Sarr will stand
still
in
two
now.
Outs.
Punch out victim twice already. EK, I'll ask you because you're the one sitting next to me. Do you approach an at-bat differently when you have two strikeouts under your belt this early in the game?
Well, you do in the sense that whatever you did the first two times.
And he'll get there in plenty of time to put this one away. And
hey, we're doing what we can. I'm
so
actually
no runs on two hits,
happy
no errors,
with the results
two men
right
left
now.
Stranded. Last half of the fifth coming. Robert Fitzgerald comes to the plate as we get started here in the bottom of the fifth.
And right here is an important time for them to climb back into this one. They definitely want to even this one up sooner rather than later.
And
yeah,
out there for the first out. Darryl
called a
Moffitt
foul ball.
Stand in to start things off as this top of the batting order hasn't found a whole lot of success so far.
In fact, just one hit between the 1-2-3 hitters combined. So apparently the table setters have not been getting their chores done.
Number 83 is there, and he'll bring this one in.
Now batting, left fielder, Kevin.
Number 83 will come
excellent.
Forward now in what could be an
see
at-bat
if I can go four
that goes
for four.
A long way toward deciding
number
this ball game.
And they better be careful, too, because they haven't gotten him out yet, so this is no small task.
A shot down the first baseline.
No, too bad.
And he'll step on the
bag
himself.
Three for four isn't bad at all.
Over. So it's no runs on a hit, no errors, and a man left. On now to the bottom of inning number seven. Robert Fitzgerald will dig in now, and he'll do so representing the tying run.
Yeah, and you're not too worried about this guy jumping the yard on you here and tying the ball game. But if he does find a way to get on base, things get a whole lot more interesting.
Number 83 is there, and he has it for the out. And he's up to third safely now with two gone in the inning.
Yeah, this will get the runner up to third with two.
Vince Adorno will step in now as his guys look for a breakthrough here with a runner in scoring position.
Yeah, and it's been a long time coming. They haven't done anything with their opportunities so far. Maybe this will be the time that they finally crack the scoreboard.
And that will conclude matters.
That's all
here
she wrote.
In the seventh. A golden opportunity to get on the board. Here goes for
it's raining.
More to come on the show Sunday Baseball after this.
Will I be able to bat again?
Will stand in for the fourth time now, still looking for his first hit of the ball game.
And he's not the only one either. This has been a great pitching performance so far. They've had these guys chasing their tails all game long.
Run.
And that'll get down out there near the wall. Around third and being waved on home. And the run will score all the way from first. It's now a 3-1 ball game.
I actually thought throwing it third might have been a good idea, but I guess not.
This is still one of the most exciting plays in all of baseball. You can see he's not stopping round in second.
Steven Barrios comes to the plate now representing the potential tying run.
Well, if he gets a pitch to drive right here, you can bet that he's going to give it a rip. But at the very least, they need a productive AB out of him right here.
No.
Fielder. To the track, to the wall, and goodbye. This
one ain't
coming
back. Well, nothing
I can
do about that. They tied this freaking game. Yep. Oh, boy, and it's up to me. Two outs.
Digs in here. Three hits, including a double to this point.
Yeah, swinging it very well up there right now. I got to tell you, three-hit games always feel good.
Hoping to keep it tied. Here it comes. There's a shot to right field.
Yes.
That's falling for a base hit. Throw comes quickly to the infield, so that go-ahead.
Kind of wish he would have went ahead and ran. He probably could have made it. Away.
And you'd like to think that a two-out single would score your guy from second, but this ball was just hit too hard, and he's forced to hold on at third base.
So coming to the plate, Rod Caudill, as he'll hit with the go-ahead run at third and two away.
And this is big-time pressure right here, both on the guy in the box and the guy on the mound. This is a great duel coming up.
And he gets ahead here with the fastball, strike one.
Yeah, even with two on and two away, this is not a guy that's going to back down out there. He comes right after him with a fastball, and he gets ahead.
Lifted in the air out to left field. Calderon is in pursuit.
Oh, well.
He makes the play. A great catch on the run. Rod Jitsi strides in to lead us off here in the bottom of the ninth inning. Set to deal on 2-2. Hit high and deep to straightaway right field. Going back is the right fielder. He tracks it down. A nice running play, and there's one.
Really, they ended up winning that game.
Well, runs at something of a premium here in this matchup, so it doesn't make it quite as hard to find our Topps player of the game.
Yeah, just a great all-around game for him here. You'll see on the line score, four hits, including that big home.
Golly, like, I had a career game, and that guy had a better game than I did. That's awesome.
So that just about does it. For EK, Psycho, and the crew, I'm Matt Vaskirjian. You've been watching MLB The Show. For more, get those smartphones and tablets out and head over to theshownation.com. Springfield wins it 4-3. So long, everybody.
12 hits, one error. They left 15 men on base. Time of the ball game, 3 hours and 37 minutes. Thank you for joining us here this
Give me a little more arm strength, a little more speed.
Please drive home safely.
Matt Vaskirjian back with the minor league. Minor League Baseball now on the show as our road trip makes a stop in the Double-A Texas League. Tonight, game two of this three-game series between the Corpus Christi Hooks and the Springfield Cardinals. It's baseball, it's the show, and it comes your way next. And with that, here's a look at the visitors' starting lineup. Who do you have your eye on, EK?
Well, Matt, I think the cleanup hitter might be the difference maker in this game. He is such a clutch hitter for this ball club.
Look, crap, I'm batting 559 now.
His position is up over 400 on the year, so expect him to cash in if he gets a chance.
Number 83 will stride in, hoping to stay hot as he
I'd
came
love to get called up, but that
afternoon.
Ain't going
to
happen for a
well,
while,
you look at the
I'm sure.
Average on the season, guys, and he's not sneaking up on anybody. Pretty amazing numbers for him right there. So yesterday's performance, obviously no fluke. Oh, you talk about being comfortable at the plate. That's the way he's feeling it right now. 9 straight games with that base hit now.
Rod Caudill will stand in here with a runner at first to start the inning. Now, I know both of you are more familiar with the art of hitting as opposed to the art of pitching, but on a wet night like this, who do you think this favors?
Well, I think it favors the pitcher. I know they're going to argue, well, the grip, but the ball doesn't carry on a wet night. So if I'm out there, I'm saying, look, pitcher advantage. Yeah, he had a chance to put him away. Had him down.
Too long, nobody out.
Will stand in. He's got that average pushing up near 300 to start the new season. And he looks at a cold strike three as the cut fastball's in there, and that's out number one. And with that, let's check out the Springfield defense. It's brought to us by Majestic. EK, what do you got? Kevin Flores will stand in, hoping to get things turned around here in April as he enters play with an average down in the 220s. 0-1, here's the pitch. Oh, it's hit to third. 5-4. Three. It's a double play and the inning is over.
Oh well.
Alan Stroud will come
we
forward
do
now.
What we can.
Back in the lineup here after getting yesterday afternoon off. Fly ball out toward right field. Right fielder has a beat on it, looks it into his glove, and there's one gone.
Batting ninth, the shortstop.
Number 83 steps in now.
Now batting, number 83.
Into the windup and the pitch. Grounded back up the middle. And that is through.
Wow, that was nice.
Field for a one-out single.
I'm actually doing a lot better than I thought I would today.
Boy, you talk about a ball having eyes. First off, he's fortunate to get this one by the pitcher. It's not hit especially hard, but you'll see.
Rod Caudill will dig in. He singled his first time around. A swing and it's popped in the air back behind first. Jitsi ranging into shallow right, and that's the second out of the inning. On to first, the double play. No runs
well,
on
I tried
a hit,
to return
no errors,
and, it wouldn't
and no
let
one
me.
Left.
Oh, well.
On now to the bottom half of inning. Marshall Bowden in now.
I don't know what that was. Looking
trip.
At the ball, it was like up in the sky, and I couldn't see where I was going.
Lifted in the air out to right. Right fielder is on the run. He's there to track it down, and that'll end the inning. Both teams battling the elements thus far, but we've got a tight game through five. Back with more Monday Night Baseball following this. Number 83 will step in now. He's singled twice to this point.
Yeah, he's just been putting the ball in play, and so far it's working out nicely for him. Sometimes it is.
See if I can make another hit.
Sharply hit ball back up the middle.
I've like nearly hit the pitcher like three times just this morning.
Back into the stretch for him again as we take a look at his line so far. It's almost like he's kept that shutout going with smoke and mirrors because he's definitely given up his share of base runners. They just haven't amounted to anything so far.
Rod Caudill steps in, working on a 1-for-2 game.
Doing
so
my
far.
Part.
Outside and low, 3-0.
And that questionable call on the previous pitch, it really changes the at-bat because he doesn't want to just lay one in there on 2-0. Now it's 3-0, and the tide is not working in his favor.
And that's over, 3-1.
Yeah, a much better pitch there than the one he threw on 2-0.
Possible go-ahead runs on first, one away. And he misses with it, ball four, so the potential go-ahead run moves into scoring position now.
First and second now after the walk, and they haven't gotten much going offensively against this guy at all. So this is
Keo Saar will step in now as his guys look for a breakthrough here with a runner in scoring position.
Yeah, and it's been a long time coming. They haven't done anything with their opportunities so far. Maybe this will be the time that they finally crack the scoreboard.
Swing and a miss, strike three. The throw. Well, he thought about going for third, and now that runner's in no man's land out there.
Oh.
Over now, they'll apply the tag between second and third.
Yeah, it's a horrible jump. I just wanted to try that out.
Prematurely over. Randall Hartley will dig in, 1-for-2. He grounded out the first time and followed that with a base hit in his second plate appearance. Pulls this one into the air out into right field. Number 83 is there, and he makes the catch for the out. Number 83 stands in.
The batter, number 83.
hit hard towards second, but right to the second baseman, and that's the second out.
The batter number 13, short
Stephen
Helton. I was really hoping that that would be the hitless to this point, difference.
But with a chance to be a hero here.
Well, he knows better than anybody in that lineup. Right. One swing could make up for a whole game's worth of struggles.
Hit high in the air down the right field line. Long run for the right fielder. Two down.
Oh, here we go.
We'll stand in working on a three-hit ball game now.
If I could get
very comfortable in the box too, and that's pretty obvious.
A base hit.
If I try to move him off the plate,
the game could be over.
Hard hit ball to second.
Of course, the one time I hit it like directly to him.
First, and that error won't come back to haunt him after all, as the inning is over. One hit, one error. Kevin Calderon digs in, looking to send something into the outfield.
I hate these extra innings games.
Run a chance to score.
I just know
second.
That my screw-up's going to be the difference.
You've got to love any game that's this tight this late.
And here's a ball hit in the air. Avery backs up and takes care of it. Two away.
Now batting.
And we lost again.
And guys, a good
we got eight
the
hits
the man you see right there,
and didn't even capitalize on a single one.
Of the game award.
Yeah, Matt, it sounds good to me. They needed him to come
oh,
out
well,
and give some support
that's
when he was called on.
How it rolls,
he
I guess.
Gave him a very good outing out of the bullpen. Enough to make him our player of the game.
So that's a wrap here tonight. For my partners in the booth, Eric Karros and Steve Lyons, and our entire crew, I'm Matt Vaskirjan. You've been watching MLB The Show. And for more, click on over to theshownation.com. Springfield wins it 1-0. Good night, everybody.
3 hours and 38 minutes. Thank you for joining us here tonight. And we remind you to please drive home safely.
The show's continuing coverage of minor league baseball is on the air. Today, the third and final game in this three-game series between the Corpus Christi Hooks and the Springfield Cardinals. It's baseball on
right.
The show, and it's
let's
coming
see
up
if
next.
I can actually help us win this time instead of just doing
one.
Good and
Eric,
the rest of the team sucking.
Number 83 will stand in for the first time now, coming off a three-hit contest in the loss last night. Swing and a line drive. But foul. Another one fouled off, and he's quickly behind 0-2. The windup and the 0-2 pitch. Drilled on the ground is short. Bowden is up with it. Throw to first will be in time, and there's one gone here to start the second. With a moment now, let's check out the Springfield defense. It's brought to us by Majestic. Eric, what do we need to know? Number 83 will be the batter. 0-1 here in the early going. He's set. Here it comes. Slap hard the opposite way. That's in there. Base hit. And they're going to hold that runner at third base.
Hey, that's
as
decent.
Even with two away, they didn't like their
guess
chances.
Got a third.
But you talk about being locked in at the plate right now. That
ten
is
game
10 straight games with a base hit now. And it's going to be a lot of fun to see how long you can keep this thing going.
Rod Caudle stands in with two on and two out here in the third. A big uppercut there as he popped this straight up. Adorno is there for it. No trouble with this one, and the inning is over. So it's a run on three hits, no errors, and two men left on. We'll head now to the home half of inning number... number 83, will stand in to lead off the inning. Middle third of the lineup, 4, 5, and 6, as they try to get something going.
Yeah, we're winning 1-0. Let's see if we can,
pretty quiet all game long.
If I can kind of help out here.
Shot towards second, but an Adam Bull right to him for the first down.
Yeah.
The batter, number 13, shortstop.
Roger Gutierrez will try it again. He's grounded out and struck out in two trips.
Yep, not showing too much so far, but he's got a chance to make something happen right here. See if he can put those other ABs behind him.
Number 83 is under it.
Yay.
And he makes the catch for out number three. Add another zero as it's up to seven shutout innings so far.
That's like the complete opposite. Now they got five hits and haven't capitalized.
Number 83 steps into the box.
And I'm going to try to make some noise here.
Now a swing and a fly ball. Hartley giving chase and foul. Into the windup, here comes the 0-1. Hit sharply toward the right side.
Right to the right fielder. Directly to him, right into the glove.
So nothing happening this time around.
At least I kept my streak up.
Darryl Moffitt will step in now as his guys look for a breakthrough here with a runner in scoring position.
Yeah, and it's been a long time coming. They haven't done anything with their opportunities so far. Maybe this will be the time that they finally crack the scoreboard.
Well hit. Deep down the right field line. But this is taken in on the warning track as the runner will tag from second. Around third and being waved on home. But not in time. And just like that, this ball game is tied.
And that's a good job in that situation. You'd love a base hit, but hey, the bottom line is you've got to produce a run, and he did.
Steven Barrios strides in, grounded out his last time through. Looking for the strikeout. Here's the 1-2. Hammers it to deep right field. Racing back the right fielder, but he can't get to this one. It's off the wall. And your go-ahead run is in there at second base as he's got himself a two-out double.
Oh, man, I tell you.
So I didn't think that was a poor throw decision.
And this would have given him a lead, but it's going to wind up hitting off the wall.
Digging in to try it again, Rod Jitsi. He looked to bounce back after striking out his last time up.
Well, at the very least, he went down hacking. Striking out is one of the many frustrations that go along with hitting. You have to accept that it's going to happen sometime.
Oh, my God.
And he will make it into second base as the winning run is in scoring position now with only one away. Number 83 steps in now.
Leading off for the Hooks, right fielder, number 83.
Takes this the other way to right, and that'll get down for a base hit. So he goes after
very surprised
the first
that was a
pitch,
base hit.
Early trouble here this half
I expected the right fielder to catch it.
Boy, he's seeing the ball well here early in this first month of the season. Here he doesn't try to do too much with this. He just takes it the other way. That average will climb even higher. He's got another base hit.
In now, Rod Caudill, already 2-for-2. He'll look to add on right here. Ready on 1-2. And they do have him scoring with two strikes as he gets this one down. Throw to first is in time for the first out.
That is good execution.
Keo Saar will stand in now in what could be one of the bigger at-bats of the ball game.
And what he has to do right here is put his 0-for-4 out of his mind. He hasn't had the greatest of performances to this point in the game, but he could make up for it with a big hit right here.
And that misses ball four. So John Avery digs in, coming off a single in his last at-bat.
Well, and everyone knows he's slumping right now, so we'll see if that got him going.
Skied into very shallow right. Hartley moving to his left, two gone. Throw behind him to second. Throw back to second, and that's a double play. So no runs here on a base hit, no errors, and one man left aboard. It's getting late. One run can win it. Number 83 stands in.
Number 83.
Hit hard to short. Bowden gloves it. And how about that right out of the bullpen? A ground ball on one pitch, and the inning is over. So it's one run on two hits, one error, and two left.
Oh, we finally won a game.
And fellas, as always, a few guys we could have chosen from, but out of everybody, that's the man who stands out in my book. He's our top player of the game.
Yeah, two hits for him in the ballgame, both of them doubles, and that really paced his guys to the victory.
So that'll just about do it for us this afternoon. Thanks to Eric Caro, Steve Lyons, and the rest of our crew. I'm Matt Vasgersian. This has been a presentation of MLB The Show. To find out more, head on over to theshownation.com. Corpus Christi.
Sure, let's do this. I need to learn how to steal a base anyway. How do I do this? This is horrible. I don't even know what I'm doing wrong. Oh, well, I'll probably never be a base stealer. I have no clue, like, what I'm even doing, so. Oh.
Matt Vasker. Now from your exclusive home for minor league baseball, MLB The Show is on the air. Now to the plate, Felipe Nieve, as he'll get his first opportunity in this one.
It's probably the last game of the day for me.
That softly hit to right. Will that get down?
That's a tough way to start a ball game.
Number 83 will stand in, and as you can see the big number there, he's up over 400 to begin the campaign.
Well, it's still early in this season, but if he keeps this up, he's going to be looking to get it.
And now, meanwhile, this is going to be extra bases, and that may just get a couple of runners home. And they'll extend their lead even further as the runs in to score from third. And not in time as the second run scores.
Nice. That's what I needed.
You know you're talking about a nice streak when you get up over 10 games in a row, and now that's 11 for this guy.
11 games in a row.
He's feeling it.
A 2 RBI double. Looking good.
John Avery will stand in, and he is off to a dreadful start at the plate as he has not hit the ball well in April. Runners on his way to third. This is hit high in the air out toward left center. Rosa is there now, and he has it, two gone. And no tag at second. He'll head back there with two away now. A chance now.
Yeah, I kind of know what I'm doing now.
Team lines up in this one. Who's the one to watch, EK? Tio Sarr will stand in, hoping to get things turned around here in April as he enters play with an average down in the 220s. He's set. Here's the 3-0. Taking all the way, and it's 3-1 now. EK, you take a look at our visitors as they enter play here this evening. Well, they've been playing some pretty good baseball, 5-2 over their last seven.
They come into this one fresh off a 4-2 homestand, so they'll be hoping to get the same sort of production as they head out onto this road trip.
Nieve scoops it up onto first, and it's in time as they're finally able to retire him.
Dang.
So they nearly bat around here as eight men come to the plate, and they push across four runs.
At least we're already winning 4-1.
Henry Blanton will dig in now. Off to a slow start, as you see there, just barely over the 200 mark here in April. Skied into straightaway right. Right fielder is on the run. He hauls it in without any trouble, and there are two away. And with that, let's take a look at the Corpus Christi defense. It's brought to us by Majestic. EK, what do you got? Felipe Nieve steps in now. Ready with the nothing and one pitch. Pulls this one into the air out into right field. Number 83, Thunder.
I'm very surprised
and he
I caught
the
that.
Catch for out number three. Pretty painless half of the inning, all told. We'll go to the bottom. Number 83 will stand in another dangerous spot here in the inning as this ball game is hanging on
Dang.
The precipice of
two
getting
outs,
out of
two
hand.
On.
Yeah, I think you have to get this guy if you're going to have any chance of sticking around. Even a single here might put this one out of reach.
Hit hard on the ground to second. Harris fields it cleanly. On to first, and that'll do it as they
directly
manage to
the second
not
baseman,
let this inning get
right
out of hand.
Glove.
So two runs. Leading off the inning, Ryan Rua. And
we're looking pretty good here.
Get something going here.
Well, you know,
6-1 in the
fourth. Quite a bit in the early going here, so they need a good inning here to get them back in the game.
Long run for the right fielder. One out. Number 83 will dig in. One for two with a double in this one.
One on yet again.
He's ready. Here's the first offering. Out in front of it, strike one. Smoked on the ground up the middle. He gets dirty, but he can't
yes.
get there, and it's into center field.
And at this point, I don't think...
John Avery will come forward now. He has flied out and singled so far. And a changeup swung on and missed for the first out.
And after that pitch was called a ball on the pitch before, I mean, I think this actually qualifies it.
Tio Sarr will try it again. He's grounded out and struck out in two trips.
Yep, not showing too much so far, but he's got a chance to make something happen right here. See if he can put those other ABs behind him.
Throw on to first, two gone.
The catcher, number 9.
Eldon Griffin will stand in again. A couple of groundouts for him on the ledger in his two trips so far.
Yeah, just sort of rolling over on it, guys. See if he can make a small adjustment and get through one here.
To short. And the two-out threat will not come to pass as the inning is over.
I was really hoping
so
I could have made it home.
Two hits, no errors, and two men
just kind
left
of doing
stranded.
What I'm allowed
five
right
innings
now.
Complete. The hooks are out in front here.
Oh, here I am again.
Number 83.
I'm trying to make it 3-for-4.
2-for-3 with a double thus far.
Yeah, he's looked very settled in at the plate in this one. He could have a little more in store for us right here.
He's running towards second. Line drive to center field. And that'll get down for a base hit.
Yeah, it's not too often that you'll see a first pitch hit and run, but it worked out here. Usually, you see it when the batter's ahead in the count. 1-0.
John Avery gets another crack right here. He's got a hit in three tries to this point. Hit sharply on the ground. To second for one. Throw is dropped to first. And a real mistake there. That's got to be an E3.
When you're already losing, the one thing you can't do is give away more runs.
I didn't even see what happened.
You're already in the hole. The last thing you want to do is keep digging, but that's what's happening right here.
Oh.
Things are going from bad to worse now.
Well, he got me out, though.
Stand in now in what
big
could
whoop.
Be a real make or break situation.
And you think at this point you have to get something out of this inning. The further you get into that bullpen, the tougher it's going to be to claw back from this deficit.
Right fielder has a beat on it, and that ends the inning. So it's no runs on a hit, no errors, and a man left.
I do believe we won. Yep. That's 3-for-4 with a double and two RBIs. Somebody else probably had a better game, though.
A handful of fine individual
yeah,
performances to choose from in this one, boys. But what do you say we go ahead and let this man take home the hardware? He's our tops player of the game.
Yeah, he was definitely a big part of this victory. You see there, 4 RBIs for him in the ball game. He came through when they needed him to, and he was instrumental in the win.
So that's a wrap here tonight. For my partners in the booth, Eric Karros and Steve Lyons, and our entire crew, I'm Matt Vasgersian. You've been watching MLB The Show. And for
you know
more,
what? I might just finish this series out.
Corpus Christi comes out on top, 7-2. Good night, everybody.
Time of the ball game, 3 hours and 18 minutes. Thank you for joining us here tonight. And we remind you to please drive home safely.
One more game. And this will be it.
Minor league baseball now on the show as our road trip makes a stop in the Double-A Texas League. Tonight, game two of this four-game weekend set between the Frisco Rough Riders and the Corpus Christi Hooks. Number 83 will stand in. He, too, had three hits in the win last night.
Well, you know, he's been averaging at least an RBI per game over his last 10, so yesterday's performance.
Well, the first baseman is under it to make the play, and that retires the side. And inning in the books tonight, still scoreless here on the show. Felipe Ramirez is into the box for his second appearance, 0-for-1 with a flyout. And here's a ball hit in the air. Avery is there to make the catch, and the side is retired. Nothing across here this half. On now to the bottom half of any
number. I need to get a hit. I need to keep that streak alive.
Number 83.
Hard hit ball to second.
No.
In time to first, and there are two away. Johnny Harris will come forward now to begin the seventh inning in what's been a very briskly played ball game here tonight.
That's what happens when you get two starters that are on top of their game. It's been great pitching, great defense, not a lot of base runners, and very even game through six innings.
Now batting, third baseman, Ramon.
Number 83 will stand in for the third time now, still without a hit, so that streak could be in a bit of jeopardy.
And I think that's in the back of his mind, but it's not something he's really focused on.
Oh, look at the diving stop to first. He's
no.
out.
Oh,
what a play.
Now batting.
Josh Huggins strides in, grounded out his last time through.
And Matt, with the double play in order, they'll obviously be looking to induce another ground ball out of him right here.
Now a swing and a fly ball. Right fielder giving chase. Now a reach, and he takes a tumble here, but hangs on for the first out. And he'll make it over to third base safely, so that puts runners at the corners with only one gone.
And let's check this one out again. Look at him spread.
Number 83 will stand in, needing to do something here to get on base as they're down to their final two outs.
Yeah, and you just can't worry about the score right here. You just got to be able to string together a couple of base runners and take it one pitch at a time, one runner at a time.
Ooh, that one deflects off him. I think it got his arm. Throw to first, but he's safe. And now the stadium's attention turns back to the man on the mound.
I made it.
He's okay on the mound.
That is great. That's like the greatest extension of a streak ever.
That was close.
Every time
I'm like hitting pitchers left and right.
Bigger. He waited until the ninth inning, but got it done.
In now, Kevin Flores. He got called out on strikes his last time through.
Yeah, it's always a frustrating thing to go down looking, but you know what? Everybody does it. So you've got to let that one go and make the next AB count.
Hit in the air to center field. Rosa is going to get there to make the catch, and now they may have a shot at doubling the runner at first.
No, you're not.
Tio Sarr makes his way to the plate, needing to make something happen. They're down to their final out in the ninth inning.
That's not looking too good for him anymore, but you know what? There's no clock in this sport, and that's for good reason. You've got to fight for all 27 outs.
In there.
Sweet.
Hit.
Oh, we got some life here now in the ninth inning. First and second now, and hey, one more base.
John Avery will stand in now, and hey, give these guys credit. They're not going down without a fight.
I'll tell you what, they're not too far away from making a game out of this one after all.
Inside, as that perhaps will back him off a bit, 1-2.
Well, you don't want to get caught looking on the final out, so that's a tough pitch to lay off.
On the ground to the left side. Fielded cleanly. Throw on to second for the force, and the ball game is over.
Oh, well. We lost. But I still got that streak. That was a really quick final game, but that's it for me. I got to go to bed.
Time for one final check of the line score as you see the key players there in this shutout victory. So, guys, all three of us were treated to a well-played ball game all in all. And what do you say we go ahead and name this fella right here as our Topps player of the game?
Well, he winds up with three quarters of the cycle. Couldn't quite squeeze in the triple, but that's all right. He definitely did enough.
All right, I'll be back on probably later tonight. I hope everybody has a good Friday. This is Lonnie. Be sure to check out my website, thelonnie.com, thelonnie.com. And I'm going to get to bed. I'll see everybody tonight.